hearing officer, really. Republic versus Nicholas Mwendwa. The ruling arises from a miscellaneous application brought under Article 49(1)(f) of the Constitution, Section 36A, CPC, of 75 laws of Kenya by the Republic through the Directorate of the Criminal Investigation against Mr. Nicholas Mwendwa Kikuku. The notice of motion application dated 15 November 2021 was supported by affidavit of number 234736, Chief Inspector Moses Nagat, who is also one of the investigating officers in the case. In his application, he sought court leave to hold the respondent for 14 days from 15th of November 2021 at the Kigiri Police Station to allow him and his co-investigators complete investigation on cases of fraudulent acquisition of public property contrary to Section 45(1)(a) as read in Section 48 of the Anti-Corruption and Economic Crimes Act No. 3 of 2003, as well as failing to comply with any law, applicable procedures and guidelines relating to the procurement and disposal contrary to Section 45(2)(b) read in Section 48 of the Anti-Corruption and Economic Crimes Act No. 3 of 2003. In court, Mrs. Onunga for the prosecution stated that the compelling grounds for the application to detain the respondent were that he was the president of FKF in the management and control of public funds advanced by the government of Kenya and other donors to develop football, and that being in that position, he had authority and influence over potential witnesses who are employees of FKF by using his influence or intimidation on the same people. The prosecution went on to state that though the respondent was arrested on the 12th of November 2021, the investigations were not concluded as certain documents were in his custody in his office, which was closed during the weekend. She went on to argue that the respondent had been brought to court within 24 hours as stipulated by the Constitution and prayed to court for 14 days to hold him so that they could conclude the investigation. The respondent, counsel Mr. Motua, opposed the application on grounds of the state had failed to show compelling reasons to detain the respondent, and to this he argued that there was a report prepared by the registrar or committee appointed by the Cabinet Secretary of Sport in respect to the management and financial position of FKF, and this could not be used as a reason to detain him. The second ground was the test of good faith. Mr. Mutua went on to state that even if the reasons could be compelling, the state had failed to demonstrate that the application for detention was brought in good faith. The court ought to deny that prayer. He said that the application for detention was not brought in good faith, and therefore the court ought to deny that safe prayer. He stated that during the respondent's arrest, the public was informed that the mismanagement was for Kenya shillings, 313 million, yet the affidavit before court gave the figure of 8.5 million and another 29 million alleged to have been withdrawn by unauthorized signatories. It concluded that it was in bad faith for the state to release a colossal amount to the public when the involved amounts were 8.5 and 29 million and that this was used to demonize the respondent in the eyes of the public opinion. He went on to state that the other reason for bad faith was violation of the provisions of the Sports Act by not showing the respondent the report which the police relied on while arresting him. Issues for determination is whether there are sufficient grounds to arrest and detain the respondent. In the case of Betty Jemutai versus Republic, which was brought by counsel for the respondent, I quote, the recent trend where Judge Justice Imurehi averred that the recent trend where a person is arrested and arraigned in court within 24 hours, specifically for the prosecution to seek extension of time to continue to detain such a person without a charge or a holding charge being preferred against such a person, is unconstitutional. The police have no authority in law to arrest and detain any person without sufficient grounds. Those grounds can only be sufficient if the police have prima facie evidence which can enable such a person to be charged with a disclosed offense. By the time the prosecution sought extension to detain the respondent, the grounds of the notice of motion application were sufficient to be on the holding charge for the respondent to be informed of the reason for further detention as per Article 49 of the Constitution of Kenya. Not bringing a holding charge after having detained the respondent for a whole weekend would seem like the prosecution was fishing for evidence. I find that the prosecution ought to have presented a holding charge as they sought extension to retain the respondent. Number two was whether there was good faith in the prayer for continued detention of the respondent. In their submissions, the prosecution raised up very valid points on their apprehension that the respondent might tamper with the evidence and the witnesses, thus the application to detain him further. But in the reply of the respondent, the counsel stated that there was no good faith on the part of the state, as they did not bring a holding charge, and also that the public had been informed that the amount in question was 513 million, whilst in the affidavit they only mentioned 8.5 million and 29 million, thus spoiling the respondent's image in the eyes of the public. I find that though it is not clear who gave the said amount of Kenya shillings 513 million to the public, it is clear that having held the respondent over the weekend was sufficient time for the prosecution to present a holding charge before the court. I also find that there was no good faith on the part of the Republic, that is, prosecution, in seeking further detention of the respondent without the said holding charge. In conclusion, the grounds stated in the notice of motion application dated 15th of November 2021 are not sufficient to keep the respondent detained as investigations are still ongoing. In any case, the bond terms given on the same date give conditions to ensure that the investigations were not interfered with. The prosecution is given 7 days from today to bring a charge against the respondent and or close this miscellaneous file. The bond terms are extended to 25th of November 2021. My ruling is not interpreted differently. What I mean is, the conditions that I gave in his bond terms are so that they do not interfere with the investigations. So I hope and expect that the investigations are still ongoing. If they need him to go to the IO, if the IO asks him to attend to them, then he's supposed to attend to them.
I think the one terms are very clear. And if I reply, I think the president will comply with any terms imposed by the court. I think we are complying, we comply in the direction.
My lady, may I have something?